Cognos Analytics has automated forecast modeling. It does all the work of creating models for time series data. You'll be able to share model information when you discuss a forecast result with a collaborating data scientist. In this video, you will see how to toggle a forecast on for line, column, and bar visualizations. What options are available to you to change how a forecast is created, and how to find information about what went into making a forecast. This is the dashboard that will be created during this video, showing the three different visualizations that you can use in forecasting. In this video, I'm creating a dashboard using the 2x2 template and the coffee sales and marketing data module found in the samples. The first visualization I'm going to add is a line chart. Sales date goes on the x-axis and sales goes on the y-axis. I can toggle Show Forecast. There's also four options that I can make changes to if I wanted to affect the forecast model. I have the option of changing things like the number of forecast period, how many prior periods I would want to ignore. I can change the confidence level for the forecast, and I can also describe what seasonality to use when building the model. The forecast items appear as open circles on the line. When I hover over an item, I can see the forecasted amount, and I can see the upper and lower bounds as well. When I click on the item, a shaded area appears, and that's showing me the upper and lower bounds across the full forecast. If I wanted to see information about the forecast, I would look in the data tray, and I have the option of either going down and selecting the data tray and pulling it up, or I could have also selected the Show Data icon. What I'm interested in is seeing the forecasting statistical details. One of the things I can see right away is the status is success, which means the forecasting model was successfully created. There's also a number of other values that I can see within the statistical details. These are all things that I might want to discuss with a collaborating data scientist. Making a copy of the line chart, I can move it over to the other area. And I'm going to make this a column chart. So I can see the same data now forecast as a column chart. And in this case, my forecast items are vertical striped bars. Making a copy again, using the same data, I'm going to change this to a bar chart this time. And I can see that my forecasted data is shown as horizontal stripe bars. And finally, I'm going to take a copy of the line chart again. And I can see how quickly a new forecast was created. And what I want to call out here is making a copy of that line chart and add a product group to the color doesn't just take that original forecast and break it out to the product groups. It's created a forecast for each of the product groups. And again, I can see that when I look at my statistical details, I can see each product group has its own information and I can see which model was used. This demonstrates how quickly Cognos Analytics can create new models for you as it gets additional data. This concludes the video showing how forecasts can be created with line, bar, and column charts. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.